up? It's Jamie James here coming to you again with Geartalk, and on today's vlog, you're in for a treat. It's a room full of gear with the man himself, Chris Condon, who is the guitar player and music director for Billy Ray Cyrus. And look at all this gear. We have so much gear to talk about. And let's get to it. Chris, can you tell us a little bit about yourself? What it is that you do? And what instruments you play?
Alright, here in Nashville, play guitar. Play for Billy Ray Cyrus. That's my live gig. And then do a lot of producing and session work around town. And this is my spot.
Sweet. And this is LFT Studios, which stands for
Lust for Tone
Studios. But with all the gear that's in this room right now, I want to get started with the amps. So Chris, can you tell us a little bit about your favorite amps in this room? Amps that you have? Anything special?
Okay, so recently I just got this Super Champ. So it's an 80s Rivera era, and I got hip to it because I think Bukovac and Troy Lancaster raves about it. And it finally popped up. I was in Guitar Center in Nashville. I saw it and I just bought it. And it's unreal. It's probably one of my favorite amps. I got a lot of amps and this one just really stands out.
And was it like a little 110 amp kind of thing?
It is. It's a 110, it's 18 watts, has a solid state rectifier. It's dual channel, but I don't use the second channel. And it's got a mid boost thing there. And I just run it out to my cabinet that's in the ISO room out there. And I have recorded with it, with the actual cabinet. It sounds great. Right now there's an Eminence Ramrod I put in there. It's a 10 inch speaker. And it's awesome. It doesn't get harsh, and takes pedals really well. It opens up. Yeah, it has something about it. It's a characteristic. It stands out above all the other ones. It's fat, but it's not muddy, and the low end stays intact. That might be due to the solid state rectifier thing.
That is really cool. So Chris, I also see that you have this AC30 over here, which sounds amazing. Can you tell me a little bit about it?
I acquired this from a buddy of mine. He had it, and I was helping him move, and kind of hooked me up with it, and it's just one of those special boxes. Actually, the first I heard of this is a Korg era. Another buddy of mine had one. I was playing at his house, and it was the best sounding box I had heard. And when I helped my other friend move, I was like, "Oh man, that's the Korg era thing." I just took it on the spot, and he played it. It's something special.
It really sure does sound amazing.
It's nuts. The only thing is, it's just it runs really hot. I brought it to an amp tech a bunch of times, and it's not the most reliable thing. But when it works, it's special. So that's just clean. It just takes pedals.
Sounds unbelievable. That sounds incredible. Chris, how long have you been on the road and been part of Billy Ray Cyrus's band for now?
I think we're going to year 4 here.
Yeah.
So.
And throughout that time, has your rig changed quite a bit?
Yeah, it's been a constant thing. It's a stereo. It's always been a stereo rig. They like stereo. So I was messing with a lot of different stereo setups, and it's just getting a little too loud for some people. Didn't like the volume, so out of spite, I gave him the middle finger, and as a joke, kind of, I brought two champs out, and it turned out to be really incredible, especially like in the ears. So I don't know what it is, but they just, I run them in stereo, and in the ears, they just...
So you run two tiny amps in stereo for Billy Ray Cyrus when you're playing live.
So there's, they're 5 watts each. So this is an old 66, I believe, is a Vibrachamp, and it has, what's in it? There's an Eminence in there. And then this one's a Marsh, and it came with, I think that's a Warehouse. But yeah, they're little rinky-dink 8-inch speakers. And Marsh is great. I got 4 of these. I have a Tweed Deluxe, Tweed Champ, a Deluxe Reverb, and this is my Princeton that he made. And I have actually, because of this, this is really cool, I had this out, and I told him how much I loved it, and he's like, well, why don't we just make Marsh? So I have a Marsh Champ coming, so I'll be running 2 Marshes.
So your next rig will be coming up, 2 little Marsh amps.
Right, yeah. So I'm going to replace the Fender with the Marsh and just run 2 Marshes. And it's great. There's no stage volume. And I just run them at 3, you know, and this one maybe about, you know, maybe 5 or something, just right. You know, so it's still clean. So there's headroom for pedals. And they work.
So, Chris, I see you have pedals here. Do you like pedals?
A little bit.
A little bit?
A little.
Show me what you got. Show me what you have in terms of pedals.
So this is the first of a couple cabinets, but let's just go through what we've got here. So there's all that. Uh-oh.
Wow. Even more.
The old rat.
Is that a real original Proco rat?
It is, yeah. This thing's awesome. It's a great fuzz. Oh, and then that STS modded that. That's killer.
They're here in Nashville too?
Mm-hmm. Oh man. You need pedals done and pedal boards made, that's the place.
Look at this. These racks just don't end, do they? Is that an original BF2 or is that
mod? Yeah, and I mod that as a Monte Alumis mod to make it less noisy, but I've been using that a ton.
Still continues, everyone. Look at that.
That's another XTS, the EQ.
Wow. Gorgeous.
Here's some Voxes, or Woz and Vox 1. Let's see what else.
Oh, what is this?
The Go-Keeper. That's the jam.
Yeah?
You could sync that up to a clock and it keeps it in time. It's a tremolo.
Oh! That's awesome. Wow. I'm guessing that's the first of many?
Yep, let's keep going.
You have a box full of pedals here. I'm guessing this is all that you have left?
Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Yeah, I'm trying to organize my life and, I don't know, trying to categorize all the pedals, but there's a couple. And then here I got this cabinet.
What is this? Oh my goodness.
There's a lot more. But, let's see, there's my mics and, my Boss pedals. Some Cornish stuff, tube driver, Analog Man.
Anything that you love and will never ever get rid of that's in this thing?
Well, see, here's the thing with why I have so much. And it's a funny story. So this pedal actually is what kind of made everything, the hoarding continue. So I had this pedal, and a few years ago, I wanted to sell it. And then right as I was selling it, my buddy called me up and wanted to buy it. I got a call for a session, and they specifically requested this because it was like a Gary Clark Jr. type thing. And I said, oh man, and I never used it. I used it on the session, I've been using it ever since, but you never know what you're going to get asked to use. So it needed that sound, and it came through in spades. And since then, I just have never parted with anything because it's always changing. I never, you know, it's always a different drive or a different delay or something, and I'm always experimenting with stuff. And then, you know, certain times you might need a certain sound. That
so you really love your pedals, Chris?
I do.
Can you show us your pedal board that you're using currently?
Yeah.
So I see this is your current pedal board that you're using, Chris. Is this what you're currently using live and in sessions?
Yeah. So this is the mess that is always changing, but this is the core of it, and then I have. Usually I'll have a few pedals on the side, or I have a little sidecar board with pedals put on it that for different effects. But generally, yeah, live, I just bring out this little guy. And it's been doing a lot of damage. It works.
What's currently in the signal chain? How are you starting things out, usually?
Okay, so you got your junk up front, and then that's going into a JHS buffer.
So that's under the book?
That's, like, right on the side here, zip-tied there. That's going to the Cali 76. RC booster, it's always on. And then, so these two are pretty much always on, unless I'm running a hot guitar, like humbuckers or something, that I turn this off. It gets a little too squashy. And that runs into the dude, which is like a high gain deal. And then kind of stack it going in. I just got this a couple weeks ago. This is the True Tone Custom Overdrive. I'm really liking it. And then that's the light speed, and that's just the jam. That goes into the EP, and then that goes into the volume pedal. And that is Justin Butler over there at True Tone makes the best volume pedals you can buy. It's Chesapeake Effects. They
so
modded
that.
So this
is a Rehouse Bus DD20, I'm guessing?
It is, yeah. And there's a couple things they did to it. So they put the tap, which is killer. I don't have to do an external tap. But what's really cool about it is that there's a clock out. So at one point, I was running the Strymon Flint, and I was syncing the tremolo to the clock. See, there's a clock out.
Yeah, right.
And you could clock it to different time-based effects, which is really cool. So that's a cool feature there. And then that runs into this.
Which is the Line 6 HX Effects.
HX Effects, which, you know, is my bypass.
So that thing activates.
Yeah, that just turns on, off.
So the last pedal in the chain.
Yeah, I think the Hall of Fame. It's just kind of chilling there.
So how do you run stereo with this rig?
Oh, so I have a little Leahy pedal. It's a red Leahy, whatever. It's a stereo splitter pedal, and I just run that into there, and then that's a cool pedal because it has phase and ground, because sometimes amps don't work together, so it solves that problem. And that's been it.
Chris is a guitar player, and you can't play guitar without your guitars. So, Chris, can you tell us a little bit about these guitars that you have with you currently?
All right, cool. So, this is my Jazz Master. I made it just out of parts, and it has Lust for Tone pickups. These are stellar. These are just Jazzmaster pickups they wound. And I love them. Mastery Bridge, RJT.
MJT?
MJT, MJT body. And then Music Craft neck. It's just a parts caster, whatever. Jazzmaster, parts master. And this thing's solid. Love it. So, but Lust for Tone pickups. That's the core of the sound there. This is kind of my number one guy here. This is another one I built, and this is a Telecaster. Dwight Yoakam, and then Billy as a Nug. And it's got a Glendale bridge. These are actually DiMarzio pickups, but I only use them because they are noiseless.
And they sound amazing.
They sound great. I love them. Here's some Lust for Tone guitars here, which are killer. But these are Lust for Tone pickups. And use these a lot.
So yeah, can you tell us a little bit about Lust for Tone guitars?
Yeah, so they're a company based out of Florida, and you know, I'm pretty much partnered up with them. He's my best friend out there, and we've been working a lot together for a long time. And he started with pickups, building pickups, and then it kind of morphed into building guitars, and they are excellent guitars. And this is you felt it before. That's the Strat with the humongous neck.
And another Lust for Tone guitar,
yep,
right here.
This is Lust for Tone, and they both have Callahan bridges. So that one's got a Callahan, this one's got a Callahan. These are the Jimi Hendrix style tribute pickups that are in here, and they are just some of the best Strat pickups I've heard. This is one I just got from PRS, and it's been getting a lot of mileage. So this is the Vela, and they described it to me as a Tele meets a Gretsch. So I guess this is their take on a Filtertron. And this is a DeArmond type old school thing. So this is, I reckon it's a single coil because it's noisy, but this is a humbucker, Filtertron deal. And they just sound amazing. And it's got a coil tap, three-way. It's got the Tele bridge thing, but it's not string through. But it is hollow body. And this thing's fat. Love it.
As you can see, Chris also runs LFT Studios, which stands for Lost Baton Studios. He does a lot of session stuff in here. And as you can see, all this wonderful outboard gear to make incredible guitar tones sound great in the recording. So what are your channel strips or your outboard gear that you use for recording guitars?
So for guitars, so mainly these, the TGs, these Abbey Road preamps, the Chandlers. It's kind of my go-tos for guitar. I really like them. For acoustics, this Cappy for acoustics, I've been loving it.
And Cappy Gear, they're a company based in Nashville as well,
yes,
right?
That's the VP321, and that I've been using that on acoustic guitars and bass, because the DI is really good. The DIs are really good on that, so I got a lot of Cappy gear.
Great.
And that stuff's killer.
That's Studio Guitar World with Chris.
Yeah, it's pretty simple, actually. It's two mics into two pre's. That's really neat. And then the antelopes, those are nice. Those are the converters, the interface. But I'm not doing really any processing. It's been really, I've been digging what I've been getting, just going right in. So.
Great.
That's it. And out there is the, right now, it's mic'd up a 412. And what you were hearing earlier through the Super Champ, that's the EG, the Eric Johnson 1240. So that's an Alnico Eminence speaker. And I've been using that this last week. I just put it in there and it's been solid. So, yeah.
So Chris, if anyone wants to find more about you and more about LFT Studios, where can people go find more about you and LFT?
You can go to LFTstudios.com. That's our studio website. And then Lust for Tone is the guitar builder pickup site. But yeah, I'm on Instagram and Facebook, so Instagram would be Chris Condon Guitar.
And if people want to see you play live, who do they go to watch?
Well, right now, Billy Ray Cyrus, and then whoever calls me.
There we go. That's Geartalk with Chris Condon.
Thank you so much.
Peace.